Lastly, on December 29th to 30th, depending on where it is that you're tuning in from across the world, we have our final full moon of the year of 2020. And how fitting that it is in Cancer. This is actually the second full moon in Cancer that we've had in 2020. The first one we had was actually an eclipse back in January, where all of these heavy hitting planets created a stellium in this Capricorn energy. So we had an eclipse in January in Cancer, which if you rewind, this was all about emotional versus financial security. This is about the home versus the career. This is about the individual family unit versus the big corporation and businesses such as the military, the government, the big corporations, pharmaceutical companies, etc., etc. So what can we expect from this full moon in Cancer? Well, first of all, it's a full moon, so we have to expect that there is new information, new details being illuminated for us that will change the course of our path and journey moving into this next chapter, into the next year, into the next era, into the next 6 month lunar cycle. This is going to be a highly sensitive full moon. The full moon does typically make everybody hypersensitive because it's emotions, it's our intuition, it's our subconscious self. But the moon is in her place of power in Cancer. That's where she rules over. And she's very focused on the home, on traditions, on the family dynamic, on what it is that we need to nurture ourselves, to take care of ourselves, and to take care of those that we love. Making matters even more amplified, we have Chiron, who is very active, now direct in Aries, really putting forth its best effort in kind of turning that pain that we've been through into a source of power. So this is going to amplify the full moon in Cancer, going to make us even more hypersensitive to our past pain, to our past trauma, to the wounds that are still wide open, and provide us with a new foundation to find the emotional security, the emotional stability that we need within ourselves and within our family unit and those family dynamics that are of value, that do need to be strengthened. We need to now renew ourselves, renew our position, and heal what is being illuminated underneath this moon before proceeding forward. So the full moon in Cancer is always a doozy, but literally taking place in the final days of 2020 and really giving us one last final hurrah, final opportunity to purge, to release, to provide endings, and to close that door on all of these life lessons that all of us just never want to deal with again. And at this point, let's nail this sucker shut. We have a lot of beautiful aspects taking place and awaiting us in 2021. Are we going to snap our fingers and be living in a totally different world, a world of utopia where love and compassion is felt from every single human being? No, but we're on our way there. This is the beginning of a very long cycle of balancing the scales of karma. And we are getting off to the right foot because of the divinely scripted cosmic events that not only we've had to go through and suffer through in the year of 2020, but literally this has been the growth and evolution of the collective consciousness and of the human race. So that is your December energy forecast. I just want to extend as much love as I can possibly send through the airwaves right now. The love and support and encouragement and validation that I've gotten over this past year has made my heart reach new levels that I didn't know that it could ever expand to. This has been a tough year. It has been a dark year for many people, and I just want to assure to you that you are stronger than you are ever, ever going to be aware of. This has been a trying time for many people, but the love and beauty and unity that has come out of some of the darkest place in humanity and in history has been shown to the world in this particular year. It has been an absolute pleasure and honor to bring you as much information as I could possibly harness and channel from the cosmic realm over this past year. And I am so grateful to each and every single one of you who like, who share, who listen in, who tune in, who just send me those quick little messages to say, you know what? I needed that. You put out a message and I absolutely resonated with it. And it validated for me that I'm not lost, that I'm on track, and that I'm not alone. And I just want to reiterate to you, especially as we move into a brand new year, that you are never, ever alone. I want to thank you so much for tuning in to December's Energy Forecast. I hope you have a beautiful holiday season, a beautiful last and final chapter of 2020. And I want you to be empowered, confident, and optimistic that you are going to have an amazing 2021. Thank you so much for tuning in. I send you all the love and support and encouragement that you've shown me right back to you. I will talk to you in 2021. Until then, stay in the light.